what were your influences as you when you started playing?
Hank Marvin. Yeah. That's all there was, you know. I mean, really, I loved the Shadows so much. I just loved his sound, and I still love it, actually. I still love his echoes and his touch. And I was really lucky to meet him a few years ago, and we did the did this thing for Fender down at Wembley, and he was there, and he was a great guy to hang out with. And he stayed all day and watched everybody rehearse. He didn't leave after he'd done his bit, he stayed all day. And he was like a big kid, he was like me, he was going, so what kind of picks do you use? What kind of strings do you use? You know, it was just like typical guitar sort of conversation, like when you meet another guitarist. And he was such a great guy to hang out with. And I was like, and he played like Wonderful Land, and I was nearly in tears because it was the first tune I ever learned.
Oh, wow.
And he played it, and I was just standing there watching. It was like, oh, it was really moving, you know, to hear him play it again.
We've talked before about this thing about the note. I mean, you just kind of implied that, that kids learn lots of notes, but they actually can't play one properly. So they're on a downer or a loser from the start. I mean, give us a nice note. What would you say is a nice...
Thank you. and he was sitting in bed. It was about 7 o'clock in the evening, actually, so he didn't want to get up too early on that particular day. But I went into his bedroom, and he had an old beaten-up acoustic guitar, and I was sort of sitting there. I said, I've got this melody, you know. I think I played the... I sung the, you know, the lead line, which was, of course, you know... all that stuff, and I was just kind of like singing it to him and playing it, and he said, it sounds really French, that, let me put some lyrics to it. So he kind of went away and he wrote the vocal part to it, because up until that point I was just convinced it was going to be an instrumental. I never thought for a moment of putting vocals on it, and he came up with this great vocal part, which was you know, I Remember Paris in 49, which was actually a very ambiguous lyric, because his father's name was actually Paris, and he was born in 49, so it's a bit of an insight for you there. So the whole thing wasn't actually about Paris, strictly speaking. It's was written really as a tribute to Phil Lynott. It comes from the Wild Frontier record around that time. That was just after Phil passed away, and I was in a very sort of reflective frame of mind when I wrote the music for that record, so a lot of it came out with this very Celtic, Irish sort of flavour. I'd also just gone back to Ireland around that time for the first time in a while, and I'd been influenced just by going back there, and then the whole thing, there were a lot of kind of memories floating around in my mind at that time, you know, of the early days with Phil and Skid Row and Thin Lizzy, the whole thing. So a lot of that came out on this record. And I had this melody which was very typically sort of so very sort of Celtic, very sentimental Celtic melody. I think it's good for anyone to remember their roots, really. And you know, otherwise, it's very easy to get carried away with the whole thing. It's good to remember where you came from, if you can.